Hello and welcome to another AircraftCompare.com video. My name is Tim and I'm your captain today. Our topic of choice today are the most successful Japanese fighter aircraft of World War II. Known to very few, the Second World War was more than a few superpowers at loggerheads. It was more of the most powerful countries showcasing their military advancements on a worldwide stage in the hopes of being crowned as the country with the best, most advanced ordnance. Japan was among the countries regarded as the best of the best when it came to technological advancement. They not only had the expertise but also had the human resources to design, develop, and use their new age weaponry. Despite having some of the best machine guns, bombs, and tanks of that era, one particular entity stood out from the rest, the Japanese fighter aircraft. Between 1935 and 1945, the Japanese military selected the best high-tech companies such as Mitsubishi and Nakajima Aircraft Company, tasking them with the development of the best fighter aircraft prototypes of that time. As a result, well over 48 different fighter plane models were developed in just under a decade, some of which were abandoned as prototypes. Below are 8 of the most famous Japanese fighter planes of World War II that dominated the World War II era. Number 1. Nakajima Ki-43 Hayabusa. The Nakajima Ki-43, or the Hayabusa, was a tactical Japanese fighter plane designed by Hideo Itokawa. The single-engine plane was fight-sanctioned in October of 1941, roughly 2 years after the first flight in January of 1939 was successful. The Hayabusa was designed to be subtle, which explains why it had a much lighter build. The Hayabusa came retrofitted with the brand new Nakajima HA-25 engine complete with a two-blade propeller. This remarkable single engine could crank enough horsepower to propel the Nakajima Ki-43 to speeds of up to 495 km per hour. The Hayabusa was also fitted with two cowling machine guns that worked in synchrony. Number 2. Nakajima Ki-27. The Nakajima Ki-27 was an all-time favorite for the Imperial Japanese Army Air Force, especially for their China, India, and Burma War. The Nakajima Ki-27 came with a plethora of upgrades that did just enough to impress the Army officials. The improvement was in the form of an air-cooled radial engine, which had a rather ingenious way of eliminating the overheating problem. The Nakajima Ki-27's landing gear was fixed. This was a correction after the Army officials had declined an earlier prototype with retractable landing gear, terming it as too complicated for warfare. The Nakajima Ki-27 fighter aircraft was officially retired in 1945 when World War II came to a close. By then, the Japanese Army had commissioned Nakajima Aircraft Company to assemble about 3,368 Nakajima Ki-27. Number 3. Mitsubishi J2M. The Mitsubishi J2M was designed by Jiro Horikoshi, who is also credited with the designing of the A6M0. The J2M's frame was sleek, streamlined, and sturdy, which made gliding and maneuvering through the air at high speeds feel like child's play. It was mostly used as a local defense interceptor by the Japanese in the Second World War. The craft packed a robust Mitsubishi Kase engine hidden behind a long cowling. Introduced in 1944, the J2M4 Model 34 came with an improved 1,420 horsepower Kase 23C turbo supercharger engine. The Jack, as the Allied forces referred to the Mitsubishi J2M, was officially retired in August 1945, only 3 years after its initial introduction to World War II. Mitsubishi had, by then, manufactured about 671 of this remarkable fighter aircraft. Number 4. Nakajima J1N1 Gekko. The Nakajima J1N1, also known as the Gekko, was famous for its efficiency during the kamikaze as well as night fighting missions. The latter was because of its sleek design. The fact that a couple of machine guns flanked the Gekko may have also played a role. One of these machine guns was a 20mm Type 99 cannon. The rest were six 7.7mm type aircraft machine guns. The Gekko was initially built to accommodate a crew of 3. The team aboard the Gekko was tasked with being on the lookout for enemy fighter planes. They were also expected to handle the devastating machine guns, in case of an encounter with the enemy. Number 5. Mitsubishi J8M1. The Mitsubishi J8M1 was a joint project between the Imperial Japanese Navy Air Service and the Imperial Japanese Army Air Service. An impressive feature of the Mitsubishi J8M1 was its light frame. In total, the aircraft only weighed 400 kilograms, meaning it could carry out the missions with incredible stealth. The main spar of this futuristic glider was fashioned out of plywood, which contributed to the drastic reduction of the total weight of the J8M1 plane. The vertical tail was also fashioned out of wood for the very same reasons. The designers also designed the aircraft to carry less fuel as well as ammunition. Only 7 Mitsubishi J8M1s were built between 1944 and 1945 before the project was officially retired. Number 6. Mitsubishi A6M0. The A6M is yet another brainchild of the well-regarded Mitsubishi Aircraft Company. Introduced in 1st of July 1940, the Type 0 carrier fighter was heralded as the best of its kind, when it officially made its debut on the warfront. Thanks to its scrupulous frame complete with streamlined features, the Zero could maneuver with both ease and grace, making it hard for the Allied forces to shoot it down. It's no wonder the Zero was quick to achieve its impressive 12-to-1 kill ratio. Unfortunately for the A6M, the Allied forces were ready to adapt, coming up with better technology that toppled the Zero, putting an end to its two-year reign. In addition to that, the fact that the A6M lacked hydraulic flaps resulted in a plethora of maneuvering issues, especially when flying at high speeds. The Zero was officially retired in 1945 when World War II came to a close. By that time, Mitsubishi Aircraft Company had already built 10,939 A6M long-range fighter aircraft. Number 7. Nakajima Ki-84 Hayate. The Hayate was first introduced into the war front in November of 1944, a year before World War II came to an official close. This fighter plane was built for speed, which made it easy to maneuver when under heavy fire. The Army Type 4 fighter was flanked with four machine guns, two 20mm cannons and two 30mm cannons. The Ki-84 had an upgraded armor, which made up for the weakness the Ki-83 had shown. The cantilever low-wing monoplane's frame was all metal. That ensured that the pilot was safe and secure. The plane also had a 65mm armor glass canopy for the pilot's protection. Before its official retirement in August of 1945, Nakajima Aircraft Company had manufactured about 3,514 Nakajima Ki-84s. Number 8. Kawasaki Ki-61 Hien. The Kawasaki Ki-61 was primarily used by the Imperial Japanese Air Service between 1942 and 1945. Takeo Doi designed the Ki-61 under the supervision of Kawasaki Company. This Japanese fighter plane had a robust metallic frame, which meant it was meant for defending at low to medium altitudes. The fighter plane had a semi-monocoque fuselage, fabric-covered ailerons, and three spar wings. The rudder and elevators were also covered with fabric. The Ki-61 Hien only had a single seat for the pilot. Before it was officially retired, the Kawasaki Company had manufactured about 3,078 Kawasaki Ki-61 fighter aircraft. There you have it, the most successful Japanese fighter planes of World War II. Thanks for watching. We release videos like this one every week. Make sure to like and subscribe.